So I'm a bit of an idiot. When this pack came out, I kind of swithered and I thought, I don't need another Wolverine, I don't need another Hulk. What a dummy I was. This pack is superb. And full credit to Matt, co-host of the 6-Inch Show with me, for going on and on and saying, this, the figure's amazing. And look, everybody said it's amazing and every review said it's amazing. So I ended up giving in. I stupidly should have bought this from Darkside. I should have bought this from Darkside Toys when it was up there. And I didn't, and I've ended up having to pay a lot more for it, and I'm kind of annoyed. But there you go. Guess what? It's back on Darkside Toys. So you can go back and order this pack again, and I think they had some loose ones too at the time of doing the recording. But it's pretty stupendous. Let me take you through why this is really an essential pack. It's the Marvel Legends 80th Anniversary 2-Pack Wolverine and Hulk. You can see the 80th logo up there. And on the side, we get some pretty gorgeous artwork of Wolverine. And on the reverse side, we get some pretty exclusive, cool artwork there of the Hulk from the original comic, so not really exclusive. And that's pretty much it. But on the back, we get this, the original comic that this was inspired from, and the two figures there, Hulk and Wolverine, if you want to freeze frame and have a little read of them. But nice little touch to add that there. I love what it says, inspired by Incredible Hulk 181, comic not available. Yeah, it would cost a small fortune, although I think there was a reprint at one point that was made out there, so you could get a kind of True Believers type version, if you know what I mean. There's the UPC should you need it, but again, in stock, or not in stock yet, but back up for pre-order at Darkside Toys online. Put a link in the description directly underneath. I would have saved myself a fortune had I bought it from them. But anyway, I bought it from elsewhere, who shall remain nameless, and paid a small fortune for it because I thought, I'm going to miss out on this pack. And I didn't. But there we go. So 6-inch scale, just under 6-inch for Wolverine, which is really correct. He's about 14 centimetres high. And Hulk stands here at just under 9 inches, or 8.5 inches, which is 22 centimetres tall. We'll get a look at Wolverine last because, frankly, it kind of sucks. Let's get a quick look at some of these Hulks. And you can see, just if I put both together, you can see this is a recent one from Avengers, just in terms of scale and size. And there's a pretty old one there from Age of Ultron. So they're all roughly in scale of Hulk, as they should be, and previous Marvel Legends figures. But this one, it is just, wow, something about this. It's the paint and the sculpt and this. Something about it really adds something big to the figure. It's just one of those figures that once you get it in hand and you have a look at it, the glam shots did not do it justice, I think. It just, the paint has really worked well across this figure. So to give you a look at all the sculpt and all the details on it, two little tears on the knee. And we've got some nice details on these pants, very stretched obviously all the way. He's got an incredible belt and waist, that's for sure. But we've got some nice effects down at the bottom. The plastic has kind of gone over the effect of the articulation there, which is really nice. And they've got the right coloured kind of backs for those pieces there on the leg. It's a shame that one has kind of, the trouser leg is kind of moved over there. But I think if you move it around, you can kind of cover it a bit more. But you get the point. It's well done and well thought out. And this little piece here, which really doesn't look like much, it's pretty incredible. This soft, bendable plastic, like a ripped shirt, is molded beautifully onto the figure. Really nice design on it, and just the way the tears are, it just works. They've added a little bit of a backwash onto a kind of grey to kind of accentuate out some of the sculpt and the design. Inside is just pretty plain stuff. But without it, something about it just doesn't look quite right to me. It doesn't quite fit the way it should. But adding that on just nails it. It just, I kind of takes me back to the original Hulk on TV, the terrible one. But there you go. So nice little touch and piece there. Again, just to show you on different figures, you could add it in if you wanted to. And it kind of fits on others. Kind of, sort of. Doesn't really, but yeah, it's certainly, it's one of the more interesting pieces of plastic that Hasbro have included in figures. And it kind of adds something to the Hulk. I can't believe it's taken this long to kind of get something that, kind of works. So it doesn't really work for him, but yeah. So there we go. Hulk without, it's still looking good, but these shoulders are just absolutely ridiculous. And what it does is really show these huge, huge joints. So I recommend keeping the white shirt on him for a better looking effect. But what we do get up here is ball joints up there, and it's all in a very plain style. So, but it is kind of well hidden if you pose the figure. But yeah, that's the only kind of downsides to the figure. Now, he does come with both a fist hand and an open hand, and the same for the other side, a fist and an open hand. So you get some swap out hands on him. Articulation on the head is on a ball joint up at the top of the head, and also a kind of movement further down below, and a little another ball joint down the bottom. As I said, you've got these butterflies back and forth. You've got the ball joint articulation there. You've got swivel on the biceps, and articulation at the elbows is a single joint. You get single joint at the wrist and back and forth there on that little peg too. We've got waist articulation. You've got a pretty good ab articulation, really showing off all the abs there, and a really pretty cool facial design. They've added some nice effects onto the hair, bit of grey, bit of white. Teeth are a little bit sloppy down the bottom. They're not great in my view. They could have been a little straighter, but they're not too bad, not too shabby. And that's it. I think the real detail on the figure is the paint, and it's very hard to see here, but we've got a very kind of lime green effect that has been added to kind of accentuate again the sculpt on the figure, and it really does work quite well. Kind of hard to really show, but they've placed it very well across the figure. Just in certain areas, it catches the light and it adds depth to the figure overall. You can see there on the pants, they don't have any paint on them at all. They're just solid purple. And that's where it just, again, that little bit of paint and extra touch just really makes it pop. So very cool figure indeed. I should have mentioned the rest of the articulation. Swivel up at the top of the thighs, double joints at the knees, and down to rocking huge mungus toes. And that's Hulk. Pretty awesome. But again, best posed and using his tearaway shirt. An amazing looking figure. Really, really good. And really just kind of a completely different look to all the other Hulks that we've had before. Now, Wolverine is a bit of a retool from some other Wolverines that we've had before. And personally, I'm just not loving that face. I wish they'd came with a different head for this guy. Not too bad. Nothing too terrible, but just... yeah, not doing it for me, and by the looks of it, it's not doing it for a lot of people. Even though it's that classic comic version, there's only so many fans I think that are really into this version of Wolverine. Tiger stripes and all, it's really not too bad, it's not too shabby. It's just, again, I think another excuse to reuse some of the Wolverine parts and pieces that we've had not all that long ago recently, so there's been a lot of Wolverines. I don't have one to hand off, hand to compare, but yeah, trust me, it's pretty much looking to be exactly the same. In his gigantic yellow spandex suit seen from space, you can then have his boots as well down the bottom. Those little blue boots, I should say. And it's nicely sculpted. There's nothing too bad with this figure, but not one I'm loving. And again, looking on eBay, this one is going very cheaply. So yeah, not a lot of people loving him. I think Darkseid have both him in singles and the Hulk. So again, check him out, link in the description below, but he does look pretty good, not too shabby, but it's that facial sculpt which, not quite doing it for me in the kind of weird Wolverine. I'm not really used to that comic version of him, but it's up to you. Let me know what you think. He does have some good articulation. You can see the butterfly joint up at the top of the arms there. It's a little hard to move, and with his kind of weird shoulder pads which move down and have articulation, but it all comes together and allows you to repose the figure. So you've got good articulation up at the top of the figure. You've then got a bicep swivel up there, double joints at the elbows, at least with flesh-toned pegs. You've then got swivel at the wrist, back and forth, and the usual kind of annoying fart around till we get it straight. Little plug-in kind of Wolverine claws. Sometimes it just takes forever to get them sorted. Anyway, you know what this is like. You've had a Wolverine figure before, I'm sure. Waist articulation and upper ab crunch is pretty solid. Waist articulation, just make sure you move that belt up just like I did, or the belt down, I should say. And you'll get a better articulation there. Pegs up at the top of the thighs, thigh swivel, double joint to the knee. I think there's a boot cut. Yes, there is. And rocking ankles and peckles. That's it for the 80th anniversary pack. And really, you're buying this for the Hulk, that's for sure. But a particularly good pack, and one that I'm really glad I picked up, and you should too. Definitely go click the link below, go get it. It's definitely, that's one Hulk you do not want to miss out on. And by the time you pay for a single Hulk alone on eBay, you could have bought the pack from Darkseid. It's that cheap. So check it out. That's it from me. We'll see you for more reviews coming up.